Despite being given a green light to return after a nasty ACL tear in the 2022 Super Bowl, the Dallas Cowboys have concerns after their latest meeting with Odell Beckham Jr. An anonymous source told ESPN's Ed Werder that the Cowboys think his recovery has not progressed enough and it's still doubtful whether he'll be able to play by mid-January. Keep watching this video as we give you the latest updates on OBJ's return. First up, getting cozy with the Cowboys. Odell Beckham Jr. has been getting really cozy with the Cowboys as he met with owner Jerry Jones and his family after a physical examination on Monday. He spent the night courtside with Micah Parsons and Trevon Diggs watching the Dallas Mavericks take on the Phoenix Suns. ESPN's Tim McMahon managed to get a hold of Beckham during halftime and asked whether we'll be seeing him play for the Cowboys. Before we tell you what he said, is it just us or does everything point at a signing here? He's chilling with the owner and his family, spending time with the team and just having a really good time in Dallas. We don't know about you, but that seems like the Cowboys might just end up signing him. But Odell didn't have a lot to say to Tim. He just said there's a good possibility and that's it. And then you have the anonymous source telling ESPN how the Cowboys aren't really confident about his recovery. He has been given the green light to return, but the guys over at Dallas think his progress has been slow and remain doubtful whether he can play before mid-January. On the other hand, Jones thinks what's more important is how a player feels about his recovery. If the star wide receiver thinks he's ready, then Jerry might just be more than willing to sign, but as of yet, nothing is confirmed. Oh, and let's not forget, there's still a big possibility OBJ might just end up going to the Giants, or at least that's what David Tyree thinks. Next, no urgency to sign him. Before chilling with the Cowboys in Dallas, Beckham visited the New York Giants and Buffalo Bills. He's been getting a lot of interest from these teams, and let's not kid ourselves here, having someone like OBJ on your side is paramount. The 30-year-old is immensely talented and adds a lot of value to the team, but it's a bit strange how we're not seeing that urgency from the Cowboys. Owner Jerry Jones has had a very laid-back attitude when it comes to signing Beckham. While making an appearance on 105.3 The Fan in Dallas, Jones did call it a super rare opportunity to have a chance at signing someone as skilled as Odell. But at the same time, not signing him isn't exactly a failure either. But one way or the other, there's not a failure here. I'm talking about the actual signing or not signing. There's no disappointment here. Jones thinks signing someone like OBJ will help the team improve a lot, but even if it doesn't go through, the Cowboys are in a good position and can finish strong without him. Plus, we're looking at it like every other signing, but the front office also needs to consider the financial aspect of the move. They're going to spend a lot of money to get him on board, and it doesn't really make sense if we can't add him to the team right now. And while Jerry knows signing Beckham will be super beneficial in the long run, the only problem is he needs the improvement right now. Moving on, is the salary cap an issue? Could it be that the Dallas Cowboys don't have enough funds to bring OBJ on board, or maybe they have enough money but don't want to allocate it to a single signing? We skimmed through the NFL Players Association's figures, and it looks like the Cowboys have about $6.3 million in the salary cap room. It's definitely enough to add Beckham, but what about a multi-year deal? That would make things really complicated on the financial end of things, right? They'd have almost everything riding on OBJ because a multi-year deal would pretty much restrict them from signing anyone else. We also have to remember how the front office has been trying super hard to open up contract extension talks with CeeDee Lamb and Trevon Diggs. Offering Odell a multi-year deal would impact that as well, so if we're being honest, Dallas will have to take a major financial hit to get him. But with 19 players set to become unrestricted free agents, it's possible they can free up the salary cap and pull off the signing and offer Lamb and Diggs an extension. It's still a really complicated spot to be in, and maybe that's why Jerry hasn't been going on air talking about how the Cowboys are eager to sign Beckham. Because let's face it, on a good day with OBJ 100% fit, teams would go to war to get him on their side. Now for, what does he want? We've been going on and on about what the Cowboys want, but what does Odell want here? Is Dallas his most preferred destination? Well, OBJ did admit he's been in contact with multiple teams like the Bills, Rams, Giants, and Packers. We can drop the Rams out of his list right away since they've been officially eliminated from playoff contention after a defeat coming from the Packers. But if we had to guess, we'd say the Giants and the Dallas Cowboys are at the top of the list. It's highly likely he'll end up at any one of these teams. And the best part is, both of these sides look very strong. The Cowboys have a really decent offense, but nothing too inspiring to single-handedly seduce the talented wide receiver. But if we're talking about their defense, the Cowboys are easily one of the best teams in the league, and if Odell is looking for another Super Bowl ring, Dallas is the best place to be. Same with the Giants. They've been really strong so far, and since Beckham Jr. has some history in New York, it might just be enough to inspire a return. And if we look at it in terms of value, he'll add a lot to their offensive flagging, but the only catch would be the Giants having to go all out with a massive contract to lure him to their side. In any case, coming off a torn ACL is still risky business, and any side wanting to sign him probably has to add that to their calculations. Following up, Stephen A. Smith weighs in. Sports pundit Stephen A. Smith came down hard on Jerry and his indecisiveness about signing Odell Beckham Jr. Believe it or not, Stephen thinks Jerry Jones would be extremely unwise to not sign the 30-year-old receiver. Smith talked about how the Cowboys don't really have a lead receiver yet, and we're not gonna lie, we gotta agree with what he's saying. We don't mean to take anything away from CD or Noah Brown, but both these guys need all the help they can get right now. CD has maybe 900 yards so far, and Brown only has an odd 300. And remember how Jerry Jones was talking about needing the improvement now and not sometime in the future? Well, Smith doesn't really agree with that and thinks even if they're unable to utilize OBJ this season, at least they'll have him locked in for the next, right? Steven actually called Jerry short-sighted since he's not looking at the value Beckham can add in the long run. Honestly, guys, he has a point here. We did mention how the Cowboys are doing really well now, but imagine having OBJ on the side. Imagine the things he could do for the offense. And yeah, coming off a torn ACL is tough work, but he's been given the green light to play, right? They can slowly start bringing him back into the mix, and he'll be starting in no time. Smith also touched up on the public perception and agreed OBJ tends to get in trouble now and then, but regardless of all that, he's still a good guy. Up next, a positive impact on the locker room. Considering OBJ's activities off the field, Steven jokingly said, quote, "That's what Tylenol and Advil are for." But yeah, apart from all that, he's a real gem when he's healthy and on the field, but when he's not healthy, he's not healthy. It's as simple as that. And well, that may be a bit too often, you can't ignore his overall positive impact on the team and in the locker room. In simple words, let's just say he's the kind of guy people want to be around. They want to learn a thing or two from him, you know, that Mavericks game he watched with Diggs and Parsons. They weren't there to recruit him or something. They watched it with Beckham because they genuinely liked him. Same with Jerry and his family. He's a fun guy to be around, and Smith can vouch for that since he's also spent a lot of time with him. And when you're such a huge team playing in the big leagues, it's important to have guys who know how to have fun and bring the entire side on the same page. Plus, Smith is a bit skeptical about Jerry's demands for finding someone who can add all that value right now. In the words of the man himself, who the is out there right now. Last but not least, the future is what counts. We think Jerry needs to drop the whole argument about adding value right now because there's nothing better than having a healthy OBJ for the next season. Imagine the things the current team could do with him on their side. It'll be a treat to watch his fans too. But let's see, we have no idea what's going on in his mind right now, and who knows, if the Giants have space for a beefy contract, Beckham might just end up dropping the idea of playing for the Cowboys. But that's going to be it from our side, my friends. So, what do you think? Will the Cowboys sign Odell Beckham Jr., or will he be making a return to the Giants? Let us know in the comments below. Please remember, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more interesting videos in the future. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you all next time.
And it's not like we shouldn't have been in it. We believe that we were going to be in it. We believe that we should have won. It just